Hello learners, today we will be talking about weathering, its type and significance. Essentially, I will be talking about physical, chemical and biological weathering and what is the importance of weathering in these earth processes. I will tell an interesting story to you. There is a monument which is called Cleopatra's Needle. This was in Egypt in 1450 and for 3000 years the Egyptian writings were unaltered and they were as such, you could read them. But later what happened, in 1800 the monument was moved to New York. When this was moved to New York, within few years because of the wet and variable climate of New York, the Egyptian writing became indistinct. Can you tell me why this happened? If you see, this is made up of a tough rock which is called granite, which is hard and crystalline. Though this is a tough rock, due to the exposure to the atmosphere, it gets altered. For example, some of the minerals get changed to clay and chips and flakes of minerals break away from the granite surface. Now, the question is, what is weathering? The breaking down of rocks and other materials on the earth's surface is called weathering. It is a slow, continuous process and happens to all substances as it is exposed to the atmosphere. Now, there are three kinds of weathering: mechanical, chemical and biological, and we have classified these three types just to understand them, but in nature these three types continuously interact with one another and sometimes we cannot distinguish exactly which type of weathering has occurred and which has overprinted by another kind of weathering. Now, if you see mechanical weathering, it is just the name itself tells you that mechanical means the breakdown in size. In this case, there is no change in composition. The rocks are broken into different shapes and smaller pieces. Essentially, it is the same big piece of rock which is broken down into small pieces. Why does this occur? You can see this photograph, breaking of a rock cliff into boulders and pebbles. You can see this big rock which is broken down into small parts. Now, what are the causes for this mechanical weathering? Number of causes are there. First one is temperature. I will explain how does it play a role. Second one is frost action. Third is organic activity. Fourth is gravity. And fifth is abrasion. If you see, temperature is very important. Any substance, if you heat and cool continuously, it will tend to break. The rocks are exposed to both seasonal temperatures as well as diurnal temperatures. And this continuous heating and cooling of the rock results in breakdown of the rock, because rock is not heated uniformly. On the surface it gets heated, but interior of the rock is cool. Similarly, in the night or in the winter seasons, the outer surface is cool, but the inner surface is not cool. Because of this differential heating, the rock breaks down, and in this case it is a pure mechanical weathering. If you see the frost action, again we know that ice has more volume than water. If water enters a rock, and because of cold conditions it becomes ice, it increases in volume. When this increases in volume, this causes stress, and when the ice melts, there is release of tension, and this continued action, freezing and thawing, results in breakdown of rocks. This is the diagram I can show to you here. If you see this carefully, you can see here on the top layer there is freezing. When freezing occurs, it expands. When this melts, this will contract. Expansion, contraction, expansion, contraction. When this occurs continuously, then you will have the breakdown of rocks. There is another term which is called frost heaving. Just below the surface, there may be water bodies or small water accumulations which can form ice lenses. And when ice lenses are formed, we know ice has more volume than water. This results in slightly raising of the level of land. That is why sometimes you see the fences and other things which you place, they get displaced because of this frost heaving process. Now, cracks can be caused by tree. Here I am only discussing the mechanical causes of weathering. You must have seen in temples and many other places that trees grow and the roots go inside the rock and break them. Why this occurs? Because the root, the tree tries to establish itself, and because of the physical pressure, it breaks down the rock. I am not here discussing the acids which are associated, which I will discuss in a separate slide. Animals also can play a role in mechanical weatherings. If you see, they move around and they change the surface by their activities. Similarly, there is a term which is called granite exfoliation. Because rocks are formed deep inside the surface of the earth, when they come to the surface, what happens? There is sudden release of pressure. When there is sudden release of pressure, because there is no overlying pressure, the rocks are expanded. This upward expansion leads to the curved breaks which may peel off in layers, and they are called as exfoliation. Gravity can also be a cause for mechanical weathering. Gravity, suppose there are loosened rock in mountain cliffs or in other areas, they can fall down. So, it becomes an agent of mechanical weathering. For example, when landslide falls, the rocks can collide with each other, and the collision of the rocks can result in breakdown of rocks to smaller particles. Essentially, mechanical weathering is the breakdown of bigger particles to smaller particles without change in composition. Abrasion. Wind-blown sediments can cause abrasion. In desert regions, what happens? The sand is blown because of the wind. There is aridity, there is no precipitation, there are dry conditions. Wind can lift huge amount of sand. When these sand particles go and fall on the rock, they abrade the rock, and this can cause mechanical weathering. Running water also carries loose rocks which scrape against each other and break. Now, we come to the chemical weathering. In chemical weathering, it is change in chemical composition. This is the most important difference. Changes occur in the mineral composition of the rocks. Minerals can be added, removed, or broken down. Many substances can react chemically with rocks to form secondary minerals. Now, what are the reasons or types of chemical weathering? Water is one of the important causes of chemical weathering. Oxidation can occur because there is oxygen in the atmosphere. Oxidation can occur. Carbonation can occur. Sulfuric acid can be cause chemical weathering. Plant acids can also cause the chemical weathering. Now, water is the most important agent for weathering. Because water is present everywhere and water has high dielectric constant, it can dissolve most of the minerals. And rocks that are dissolved in water easily are said to be soluble. For example, the limestone rocks are easily soluble. Why it becomes soluble? Because when the water falls in the atmosphere, there is carbon dioxide. They can also combine to form carbonic acid, which I will explain again in a carbonation process, which can increase the acidity of the water and cause the rocks to weather. Now, the chemical reaction of water with other substances is called hydrolysis. Common materials undergoing hydrolysis are the feldspars, hornblende, and augite. Oxidation. Since oxygen is present in the atmosphere, chemical weathering can take place. Oxidation is the process in which oxygen chemically combines with other substance. The result of oxidation is in the formation of entirely different substance. You must be familiar that certain iron minerals get rusted when they are exposed to the atmosphere. This is because they are easily attacked by oxygen. Good examples are magnetite, pyrite, dark colored ferromagnesian minerals. The other process which helps in chemical weathering is carbonation. As I explained earlier, carbon dioxide, when it dissolves in water, forms carbonic acid, and this acid is a weak acid, and this acid can cause the chemical change to occur in the rock. If you have seen caves, normally the carbonate caves, they are essentially formed by these process in which carbon dioxide from the atmosphere is dissolved in the water, and these carbonic acid corrode the limestone rock, which are weak in nature. The drawback of these kind of process are monuments can be degraded. Because it is carbonic acid, suppose there is a monument made up of limestone or weak rocks, they can be degraded because of etching. Sulfuric acid is a different problem. It is also caused by pollution in the air, and also when you burn coal, you release sulfur dioxide. When you release sulfur dioxide, these can dissolve in water, and this is a stronger acid and can cause lot of damage. Acid rain is a serious global problem, and we have to do everything to see that the emissions from the industries do not carry these gases, and we try to control them at the source. Now, plant acids are natural acids. The plant, in addition to the process I explained, mechanically breaking down the rocks, also secrete certain acids. These acids can result in breakdown of rocks. Biological weathering. This is the result of action by living organisms. What I said trees and plants do, I explained without taking biology, but if you take the acids released by them, then this becomes biological weathering. It is really difficult to distinguish whether it is purely chemical, biological or physical, because in nature all these processes occur together. Suppose you have mosses, lichens, bacteria which grow on the rocks, they may produce certain compounds, chelation, all these processes can go on and they can break the material. This is a very interesting photograph. What you see in this is lichens growing on the rock, and what these do is they locally increase the carbon dioxide level, and when water falls on it, carbonic acid is produced and these cause the dissolution of rocks. This is an example of biological weathering. Now, this burrowing of animals also causes the weathering. Do you know the difference between weathering and erosion? Weathering means breakdown of rocks and there is essentially no movement. But when I say erosion, it means movement of rock and minerals by geological agents such as water, ice, snow, winds and gravity. So, the difference is in weathering there is no movement, in erosion the geological agents cause the movement of the particles or the rocks from one place to another. I give you an example of river erosion, where you must have seen the rivers and streams run off and carry huge amount of rock material along with them. If you have seen the cold regions, you can see ice erosion. The ice are huge glaciers and they carry huge amount of rock material from one place to another. Wind erosion occurs in those areas where there is less rainfall and dry conditions. Wind is very active because vegetation is less there in those areas, and they can carry huge amount of dust, the sand particles and other material from one area to another. And all these processes I explained are erosional process in which the material is transported from one area to another. Now, on what factors do you think the rate of weathering would depend? Obviously, the rate of weathering will depend on the composition of the rock. It will depend on the amount of time the rock is exposed on the earth's surface. It will also depend on the amount of exposed surface on the rock. Now, composition of rocks is very important. Two different rocks in the same climate can weather differently depending on the mineral makeup. There may be two rocks in a region. Both may have different rate of weathering though climatic conditions are same. If a rock doesn't weather, it is called a stable rock, and a rock, for example, limestone is a stable rock in a dry climate. But in a wet climate, for example, if you go to Meghalaya where there is heavy rainfall, these kind of rocks weather easily. Duration of exposure, it is obvious the amount of time the rock is exposed on the earth's surface also affects its rate of weathering. A old rock which has not been exposed to forces of weathering can almost remain unchanged. If a newly formed rock is deposited on the earth's surface, it will begin to weather right away. So, the more the exposure, more will be the weathering. Amount of exposed surface, this is obvious. You must have seen that sometimes we cut the vegetables into smaller pieces to cook them. Why do we do this? Because it cooks faster. The amount of exposed surface of rock also affects the rate of weathering. As the rocks are broken down into many small pieces, many rock surfaces are exposed and weathering takes place. For example, if there are joints and cracks, more weathering will occur because water can move through these cracks and cause that. Now, I can show you a diagram here. Now, you can see that if you break this cube into smaller and smaller pieces, more area is exposed per unit volume. The greater the surface area exposed to weathering, faster is the rate of weathering. This is the reason why smaller particles or broken pieces of rocks will weather more than an unbroken piece of rock. Now, what is the significance of weathering? The first and foremost is it produces soil. If there is no soil, there is no life, no plant, no animal. So, weathering is most important process. Second, weathering prepares the material for further action by geological agent. I said to you about the erosional processes, and these processes are water, wind, waves, glaciers, etc. They are called geological agent. These materials are transported by geological agent. The third important thing is it changes landforms. If you compare Earth and other planets in the outer space, the Earth has a very rich diversity of landforms because of weathering process. If you see other planets like Moon or Mars or any other extraterrestrial object in the space, you will only see the impact cratering. You will not see the beautiful topography which is caused by weathering. Now, the question here is, are there some economic deposits formed due to weathering? Weathering, what it does, it removes some of the mobile elements and leaves the immobile elements. And what it does, if in such a case of weathering, when disintegration and decomposition go on, soluble parts are removed and insoluble residues accumulate, forming residual deposits. We all are familiar with aluminium, which we are so much dependent, and bauxite is an ore, which is an important example formed due to weathering. Can there be similar process in other planets? Now, you may be wondering why I asked this question. Other planets we know do not have oxygen. For all practical purposes, we also know they do not have water. If at all in the past, Mars or some other planet might have had little water. So, the question is, there the weathering which will occur will be of a different kind, and this is called space weathering. Space weathering is the damage that occurs to any object exposed to the harsh environment of the outer space. Bodies without atmosphere incur many weathering processes. For example, collisions of galactic cosmic rays and solar cosmic rays, irradiation, sputtering from solar wind particles, bombardment by meteorites and micrometeorites. Now, these processes affect the physical and optical properties of the surface. Since we don't go to the other planets, we only get the remote sensing images, we should understand what kind of space weathering takes place, because our interpretation of the planet depends on the remotely sensed data which we get from the satellite images. So, these processes have to be understood. Now, there is a question I want to ask you, that is weathering important? Ultimately, life depends on weathering and release of nutrients. If there is no weathering, there is no life, because the rocks lock the nutrients and weathering is the one which unlocks these nutrients, and these are released into terrestrial ecosystems. Even if you see the oceans, life is limited by the availability of nutrients. If you see, the productivity is highest on the continental shelves and in the regions of upwelling. Learners, you must have seen by now that what is weathering, what are the three types of weathering: physical, chemical, biological, and also I told you about the significance of weathering, what are the three important significance. Also, I tried to raise your curiosity by asking whether weathering occurs in outer space, whether weathering is related to life, and is there some economic deposits related to weathering. Hope now the concepts would be relatively clear. Thank you.